This is episode 2 about macros, specifically for the Atem Mini series switches. In this video, I'm going to show you how to build a macro from scratch using the free Atem Software Control app. If you already haven't received a copy of the macro bible with over 200 macros for the Atem Mini series switches, described in detail, watch part 1 if you want to get a hand on that book right now. My name is Peter Imsalbaas and this is Training on the Job. Especially when multiple settings in the Atem Software Control app have to be altered or set quickly, macros are very convenient to use during live stream productions. But also, for example, to operate a switcher via a Stream Deck device if the presets of the companion software don't contain the operation you're looking for. I personally prefer operating just one device instead of two, for which reason my Stream Deck is packed with settings and a large diversity of macros. Now, out of the box, the Atem Mini series switches do not contain any of those, so we will have to build them ourselves using macros. In this video, I'll show you one example, which I hope may inspire you to further experiment yourself. It's a square picture-in-picture macro in the bottom right corner of the canvas, which we are going to build in two different sizes. Picture-in-picture settings are often used for presentations, whereas the presenter can be seen on screen while talking about his or her presentation, and all which is also visible for the viewer, of course. I have built 12 macros for picture-in-picture layouts, which are embedded in the book I mentioned before. Each one easy to replace by another one by the click of just one button on my Stream Deck XL. Now, for the purpose of this video, I assume the initial design of the picture-in-picture image in the canvas has already been finished. In this example, the settings in the DVE panel, DVE stands for Digital Video Effect panel, in the Atem Software Control app will be set at a value of 12.8 for the X position and -5.9 for the Y position, a size of 0.3, and a mask left with a value of 5 and a mask right with a value of 7. This is how the picture-in-picture should look like. Now, to create a good working macro, you need to take the time to actually fill in the numbers in the DVE panel of the upstream key you've chosen. Even if they already exist, for like the x-axis value or y-axis value. If not actually written, the software doesn't recognize this as important and it won't embed the instruction of the x-axis or y-axis value in the macro. For the picture-in-picture, I always choose upstream key 1, but you may choose any other upstream key if available. Check out my video about upstream and downstream keys if this terminology is not quite familiar for you. And make sure it's set to DVE, Digital Video Effect, in the palettes panel. Furthermore, if you don't want a shadow, though it's already disabled in the palettes panel, it's a good practice, nevertheless, to enable and disable the shadow option. Now the software will recognize the last setting and write it into the instruction in the macro created. The same is for border or other settings. Now we are going to build a macro with the Atem Software Control app, and we start opening macros, Shift Control M, and I'm going to set this at the place in my macro panel number 100, picture in picture. We give it a note, picture in picture 30%. 30. Record. Now, it is important to record everything which is important in the image the way you want. So if we need it to be a digital video effect, which it is, we're going to set DVE. And even if it is already on DVE, you should go back to, let's say, Luma and then to DVE. The color or the fill source is not yet relevant. We're going to set that as the picture in picture will be enabled. The position I'm going to set at 12.8. The Y's for the X axis, the Y axis is -5.9, and the size is going to be 0.3 for both the X and the Y axis. I'm going to set a mask on the top of 0, on the bottom 0, the left 5 value, the right is going to be the value of 7. I'm not going to set a shadow, so I turn it on and off. Even if it's already off, you should enable and disable it for the macro to be registering how the setting of the shadow should be set. Same is for the border. I turn it off. This should be the picture in picture we want to see. Here it is. Now I can stop recording. And when I go to run, I enable recall and run. So every time I push a macro button, the button will react immediately. Here it is, picture in picture 0.3. Now, if you think 30% is a little bit too large for a square picture in picture, it's easier to adjust the setting or any other setting from the macro into the macro itself compared to starting all over again with the settings using the Atem Software Control app. I'll show you what I mean. First, let's save the XML file with the macros only on your desktop. Open this XML file with a text editor. I prefer Atem, but you may use any other text editor. Now search for the embedded macro you're going to change. Change the value of the X size and Y size from 0.30 to, let's say, 0.25 or 0.20, if you wish. Save the XML file back onto your desktop. Go back to your software control and restore the adjusted XML file. Now you want to add another similar macro, let's say with no masks or a bigger size or a smaller size, whatever. Copy and paste the macro you just created into your XML file. Give it another index number and only change the values you want to alter. That's easier compared to starting all over again and setting all the settings from the Atem Software Control app. Chances you forget something or you make a mistake and it's not a look like. I hope this video is helpful for you. If you have any questions or requests, please let me know in the comments. And please don't forget to subscribe. Many of the watchers don't subscribe, but it does help me making those videos, and it's taking quite some time to make them. So if you haven't subscribed already, please do so. hit the bell button so you'll be notified once a new video is coming out, and give this video a big thumbs up. Thank you for watching, and see you next time. Bye.